Here's a bit of a rattlesnake.
There are a number of brands that are featured in this video, which include Quesada, BarBurrito, Mexican Bowl, and Burrito Boyz. I have ordered every filling item that is offered, so the burritos are fully loaded. I have ordered the most expensive burrito at each restaurant, so it's only A-list items in this video. The main criteria that we will be using to review includes the fillings. I'm looking for a good selection and a lot of them. The distribution is a big factor here as well. I don't want to have one half full of veggies with all the beans and cheese on the other half. The tortilla, is it warm, soft, and tasty? The bigger the better. My subjective opinion of the overall taste of the burrito. And of course, the overall value. Are you spending your money wisely, or would you be better off getting a $5 burrito from Taco Bell?
Hola amigos, four burgers and fries went down way too easy. So today, I'm upping my game with four burritos, each one bigger than my head. Grab your sombreros and maracas because it's going to be burrito full.
All right, so you may be wondering, why is he inside? Well, due to extremely high winds outside, you couldn't really hear me that well. It was pretty echoey. Just makes for a better quality video to be inside. Sorry, I don't have the proper audio to deal with that. If you want to e-transfer me, feel free. I'll get myself some better audio quality and I'll shout you out in the next video. Anyway, so to start us off, we got Quesada here. We got the regular burrito. This is their beef barbacoa. Staff there are excellent, excellently made, and it was quick service, so gotta love that. The beef barbacoa, we've loaded this with beans, rice, cheese, cilantro, coleslaw, corn, diced tomatoes, guac, jalapenos, lettuce, pickled onion, red onion, veg, queso, and we've put on medium salsa to be on the safe side here. I'm not trying to get too spicy. Tortilla wrap is soft and warm. It feels and smells very good, so I'm excited to try this beef barbacoa burrito. Now for a big ass size, it's $17, which is quite the upcharge from a small or a large, but I mean the big ass ones, I've got them before, they are pretty big ass, so yeah, they're huge, they're like a foot long, so this one's the large, a bit smaller, but more efficient on your wallet. All right, let's try out this beef barbacoa. So the sauce is really good. The chipotle is really good. If you can see in there, all the toppings have been distributed well, which I like to see. It's not like you have a bunch of rice on one half and then all the veggies on the other. The refried beans are spread throughout as well. So that's really good. Prices at Quesada are extremely fair. You get an absolutely monstrous burrito. And I have no complaints about the quality either. With a friendly staff team and excellent quality service, I rate these highly. All right, so next on the list, we have BarBurrito here, which is actually the biggest burrito in this list and the best value. For $13.29, we have their steak burrito, and it's large. And let me tell you, it is large. This is a huge burrito, almost twice the size of the Quesada large. Then again, Quesada also offers the big ass, which is closer to size, but I mean, this may be the biggest burrito I've ever seen. It is huge. So the burrito's been absolutely stuffed with the same fillings as Quesada. The only difference is, unfortunately, guacamole is an extra charge, but BarBurrito has an extensive list. As I said, this is a humongous burrito. It's probably the size of my arm, actually, and I don't even know if I can lift it here. I may have to bring a fork and knife to this game because this is about to fall apart. That's how big it is. So let's give it a try. Now the one thing is, if you can see there, the rice is sorted towards the right side and the veggies are sorted towards the left. Not a big issue, but just something to note. It probably is tricky to make up this burrito when it is so big. But that's really tasty. All right, things are getting a little messy towards the end here. A little bit of spice there in that one. Nothing too major though. It's a good touch, and the chipotle mayo is really good as well. Steak tastes fresh, just like the topping. I guess it's a little overdone, but nothing really to complain about. All right, next up, we've ordered another whopping burrito here from Mexican Bowl, which is a smaller Rhine franchise in Barrie. It's very authentic Mexican food, so if you want to go and get that authenticity out of it, it's really realistic, and the vibe was awesome. This large smoked trout burrito actually cost $12.50, making it a pretty good value considering it's got smoked trout in it, which is normally around $12.50 a pound as it is. And this burrito definitely weighs more than a pound. It's a heavy burrito, so this is a cheap option. Pack this burrito with some timeless flavors. It's got all the classics, plus pico salsa, quinoa, and two types of mayo. Let's see if this thing tastes as good as it looks. Don't mind my plate. We got a little cross-contamination going on there, but nonetheless, we'll see how this tastes. Oh, the ancho de chipotle dressing just adds a great touch to that. The trout is delicious. You can see this burrito is very well mixed, made up very well with all the toppings distributed properly. The trout's in there too, and everything is just filled together, so that's awesome. Big bite of smoked trout right there. That's good. Absolutely destroyed that. Whoa. This joint offers a very authentic taste. It's got all the spice and vibrancy of a proper Mexican meal. And the price is right too. Pico de gallo is tasty, and so is everything else in this burrito. Smoked trout is innovative and creative, and makes for a delicious burrito. So why buy a plane ticket to Mexico and risk getting coronavirus when you can buy a $12 burrito and get all the experience you need? Head over to Mexican Bowl on Ann Street. It's a great place. All right, so finally, we will review Burrito Boyz. My fondest memory of Burrito Boyz is going here after a night out in university and getting one of their burritos when you really want something filling after a long night, and just getting one of these and being with the guys. I really appreciate that memory. So we'll see if this tastes as good as I remember. Here we have their calamari burrito, which costs $15, another big and stuffed burrito. And when you got calamari in it for 15 bucks, you can't really complain. This burrito has been filled to the brim with a magnitude of toppings. We have beans, cheese, rice, multiple types of onions, pepper, lettuce, tomato, cilantro, corn, jalapenos, coleslaw, sour cream, salsa, guac, chili lime, burrito sauce, and a little bit of their triple X homemade hot sauce. So excited to try that, even though I'm not a spice guy. We'll see how that tastes. Burrito Boyz also gives you the option of 5 different types of spiciness. So I've gone on the conservative edge of things with their mild, level 3 out of 5. Oh, clean on the inside, messy on the outside, just how I like it. There's something that hits different in that sauce. That's amazing. Never have to be their homemade house sauce. That's very good. And there it is. You can see the homemade triple X sauce in there. All the rice, all the fillings, all the good stuff. And that's what I call a good, nice, well-made burrito. Calamari tastes like I'd eat it just by itself. That's awesome. This burrito is big and jam full of ingredients, so you're definitely getting a better, heartier meal than just going to McDonald's after a night out. I would definitely suggest going to Burrito Boyz next time. Well, folks, that's a wrap. Hit the comments if you have any thoughts or other opinions, or you just want to say hey. Hit that like and subscribe if you like this video. It just lets YouTube know that you want to see more of these videos. We'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.